to this group. Boy, we sure came together in Nashville. Thank you for being here and for coming together to have a great time in Music City. I look out at this audience. I remember 10 years ago when we were first going to come to Nashville, and I said to the team after Orlando and Washington, do you think anybody's going to show up in Nashville? And boy, was I wrong. Look how you've shown up. Thank you. Give yourself a big round of applause for making it here to Nashville. And this is a very special jam for us. Jen Zabar is celebrating our 20th anniversary. I can't believe it's been 20 years. You know, I feel like I'm only 20 years old, but actually our baby is 20 years old. Your baby is 20 years old, and we've made it a long way together doing a lot of great things, and we're gonna have the greatest jam ever for our 20th anniversary. And one of the things that is making it such a great jam is the way that we've been able to collaborate together over the last year. Those of you who were with us in Washington for last year's jam will remember that we announced our Jen Zabar listening tour. And we said over the next 2 years, we would be traveling all across the world to see every institution, every client, to get your input as to what you wanted to see in terms of the advancements that we could make with the Jen Zabar One platform that we had announced last year. So when I got back from Washington with the team and I looked at doing a worldwide listening tour, I thought, boy, you know, we signed up for quite a bit. All these countries, all these clients, every state and county in America, how are we gonna get there? How are we gonna get to all of these places in a year or so? And the team, brilliant as they always are, said, Bob, it's gonna take new technology. We're gonna have to get some new technology if we're gonna go everywhere within a year. And so I said, okay, let's do it. So they called some of their friends at the Avengers, and they said, you can use our spacecraft, and we'll give you this Iron Man suit. A little hard to get used to, but once you get used to it, you'll be able to go everywhere and visit everyone. So of course, I took them up on it all over the world with that Iron Man suit, and I came to every one of your campuses. I hope you saw me there. No, actually, I didn't do that. But with the help of hundreds of Jen Zabar associates using planes, trains, automobiles, technology, a few buses and Ubers, even a bicycle or two, we got out there and we visited all of our campuses and we got to talk to all of our clients. We actually had over 50,000 conversations with you in the last year. We had our account managers make over 500 visits to your institutions. You signed up in record numbers to be on our advisory group. So we had over 200 institutions that volunteered your institution and your people to work with us over the course of the last year to give us feedback and input on what we were doing to advance the Jen Zabar One technology. We had RUG meetings, we had webinars. Last year at JAM, we started with many of you here in this room to have conversations. We want to continue those here at this JAM and into the new year. And through all of these conversations, I got to hear something that sounded familiar, something that I'd actually seen in survey data before about what was Jen Zabar's greatest asset. What did you believe was our greatest asset? And I was hoping it would be me, but it wasn't. It was actually our people, the Jen Zabar team, the Jen Zabar associates, our staff. And why? Because our staff is focused on your success. One client at a time, one institution at a time, they want to make sure that they help you succeed in what you're trying to do in your job and in the strategy for your institution. And so that's what makes our associates our greatest asset. And they have this attitude which we bring here to JAM, which is reflected by my good friends Cogsworth and Lumiere, that we want you to be our guest here in Nashville at JAM, and we wanna be at service for you. We wanna be Jen Zabar at your service, and we've always been at your service. And in order to be at your service, we have to be by your side. And so we made a commitment long ago. I remember making it in JAM 2003. Some of you might have been in the room then. We said that we would leave no platform behind. and we would leave no client behind, we repeated last year. So whatever technology you're running on, we will stay with you until you're ready to make the move. Of course, we want you to make the move to new technologies, and we're going to be encouraging you to do so, and we're going to be bringing them to you and trying to make them attractive for you to move forward with us onto the new technology platforms. But we won't do it at the expense of abandoning any of you as clients. We will stay with you. At the same time, over the last two decades, we've seen how new demands and new technologies came forward that we had to address. 20 years ago, we got GenzaBar started with the advent of the internet. Coming out of the 1990s, we saw that portals and learning management systems were going to be important additions and have become such over 20 years for higher education. So we started developing our JICS portal, which we use today. And instead of doing it for each individual platform, we did one product, one platform to work for everybody. And we continued that when it came to what we used to call non-traditional students, now continuing education. We said, rather than make a separate product for all of these different platforms, let's make one higher reach platform for everybody. As mobile became more important and mobile devices were critical to the success of your ability to communicate with others, we developed one mobile app. Likewise, as we started to focus even more intensively on student success and retention and persistence of graduation, we developed one retention management system for you. More recently, our financial aid and advancement systems have been developed to work for all of our clients. And our cloud and managed services, one team, one set of offerings for all of our clients. So we've been going down these parallel roads. Supporting the technology, the platform that you were on, at the same time recognizing these new demands and the new needs that we would have to address with new technologies and doing it for all of our clients on one platform. Well, over the last 5 years, starting with the cloud, where increasingly when you're in the cloud, things can converge. You don't have to worry about some of the things that made us have to have these parallel roads. So we've seen the two parallel roads converging. And as we did our new developments in Java and .NET, we saw the opportunity to bring all this together as one GenzaBar team focusing on one platform for all of GenzaBar, GenzaBar One. And that's the platform that we talked about last year bringing for all of you. So our commitment then was that in addition to what we've been developing, starting with the portal 20 years ago for one platform for everybody, we moved into our JX developments for advancement and financial aid. And last year, I renamed those JX products GenzaBar One. Why? Because those products are available to all of you. And they're available so that any institution that finds value in that financial aid system or in that advancement system can use it, regardless of whatever platform you're on today. And then we made the commitment that over the two-year period, we would get GenzaBar student and financials and HR done for you on one platform that all clients could move to. We would combine our teams that were working on EXI and .NET technology and our team that was working on the JX student technology. We'd put them together, we'd bring out, we'd double down on the resources and we'd bring out the best student and financial and HR system for you. And we would aim to do it by 2019. Well, actually, that's not going to happen. It's ready now. You're going to be able to get it here today, not in 2019. You're going to be able to see it. And you're going to be able to experience it live here in Nashville, working for anyone who wants to get started on GenzaBar One's entire suite of technology today. And today at 5 o'clock, for those of you that come back, I'm going to do an in-depth dive on GenzaBar One. We're going to do a half an hour product demo of it. I'll talk a little bit more about it in depth. And as an additional incentive, if you see this nice hat I'm wearing up here that says GenzaBar One, if you come back, I'll give you a hat. So please come back at 5 and join me for the in-depth view of what we've got with GenzaBar One. Now, I said it's ready now. Well, actually, the reason it's ready now is because we've had some brave clients that have been working with us for a number of years to push forward this technology. We know it's not easy. We humbly say we are so grateful for your indulgence and for your grace to let us work with you, especially these pioneering institutions, to be able to get these through these technologies, to work out the bugs, to make it work so that everybody can then take advantage of it. You know, and hopefully now that we've had these early pioneers, who I'm going to recognize in a moment here, we will also be able to have a lot of fast followers. So I want to say thank you to our friends at Baker College and at Polk State who have been very successful, yay, and have worked with us over a number of years. You know, we have president of Baker here. I don't know where, you know, where you went, Bart, but if you and Jackie and your team and Naomi, the CIO of Polk, if you could all stand up, and anybody from these institutions, please stand up. I'd love to give a big round of applause to you for all of your effort to get Gensibar 1 live for everybody here. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, at Baker, they have worked with us on the JX trail and have gotten the JX modules going. They've recently gone live on Gensibar Financial Aid. It's a great system. They're using it live. You know, you can see what they're doing there. At Polk, they've not only gone live on Gensibar Financial Aid, they're also implementing, as we speak, the Gensibar 1 student and business office suites. And so if you race out the door and sign up quickly, you might be able to beat Polk and be the first one to be up and live on Gensibar 1. But they've already got a head start because they're already working on it. So if you're going to be a fast follower, you're going to have to move quickly. So I really appreciate what they've done to help us get to where we are. And of course, there's going to be a lot of other things for us to see and do together here in Music City. You know, not only are there going to be lots of sessions for you to go to and lots of other people to share with, you know, we're going to have some fun in Music City. You know, we have a big party on Friday night, and we're going to just go out and have some good old time downtown Nashville. And Nashville, as you know, is famous for country music. You know, you got the Country Music Hall of Fame here, and it seems like every week there's a new country star that emerges out of Nashville. And so this is definitely a country music town. But it's called Music City. And so it's not just about country music. As a matter of fact, if you do go downtown to Nashville, you're going to find B.B. King, and you're going to find Rudy's, and you're going to find like a dozen other great jazz clubs. Some of the best jazz clubs in the world are right here in Nashville. Beautiful jazz music. We like the jazz in Nashville, but we actually love the jazz that we have at Gensibar. At Gensibar, we call it Gensibar as a Service. J-A-A-S, jazz. So we're going to make some great music here with our Gensibar as a Service, our jazz, which is the way that we ideally want to bring you our Gensibar 1 technology. Some of you are already running our jazz way of doing things, and you're going to learn more about it here at JAM and in the weeks and months to come. But when we think about Gensibar as a service, you know what? It really occurs to me that Gensibar has always been a service. You know, when we started out writing the first lines of code, almost 50 years ago, some of our predecessor companies that are in the room started writing code in the early 70s. When we did that for the software, we didn't just mail you a floppy disk and say, have a nice life. We always provided a service. We provided maintenance and product enhancement services. We provided telephone support. We provided training, like here at JAM. So we were always working to be of service to you, to be Gensibar as a service, not just a software company, a software and services company. And so that's been our long-term and long-time commitment. That's who we are as a company. And recently, in this last decade, we've added more important services to that offering. So, So we have now introduced, starting around 2010, a little bit earlier, managed services, our remote server management services, our RDBA services, and our cloud hosting. And we introduced it at a time when the world was starting to look at cloud and starting to move to cloud in a big way. And I'm just so thrilled to to say that the people in this room and across the country and around the world that are Gensler clients embraced this move to the cloud. And today, we have over 175 clients running their full ERP in the cloud. And for those clients who've been with us over the course of this last decade, 99.5% retention rate. If you're running with us in the cloud, then you are going to be a successful institution. I don't know what happened to the one, where they went, but 99.5% of 175 clients are still with us in the cloud. So together, when we work on these cloud and managed services technologies, it works. And so I really hope that everybody here will begin to take a serious look right here at JAM to think about moving with us into the cloud. And already I see that so many of you are. We have 350 active managed services projects going on today around the country, around the world with all of you. And that means that more and more of you, I hope, are going to be coming into the cloud with us. And I feel like I've reached a point in my career where I've kind of come full circle. When I was 16 years old, a while ago, I went to the local restaurant in my town to get my first job. And I went in and I said, I'd like to work here. And the manager of the restaurant said, well, son, the only thing we've got is washing dishes. I said, I'll take it. I said, without someone washing the dishes, you can't have a restaurant open. That's an important job. I'm glad to do it. So I signed up for my first job to get my first paycheck. I wanted to actually be able to put some gas in my car. I didn't care what it was. I was going to take the job. So I started washing the dishes. And I had great aspirations. I saw the busboy bringing all the dishes into me. I thought, maybe next year I'll be the busboy and I'll be able to bring the dishes in and I won't have to be just the one that's washing them. And I never really aspired to be the cook, you know, up there, you know, kind of like the chef, you know, kind of making the meal. But I was happy washing the dishes. And so when I talk to you about cloud and managed services, not to insult any of my people or any of you, I think of it as washing the dishes. And what I would like to say is, let us wash the dishes. You do the cooking. Now, what I mean by that is that whatever function you're in, we would love to free up your time to focus on the strategic priorities of your institution, what your president and your executives on your campus want to accomplish so that you're working with students and staff, faculty and alumni and parents and others, and you're doing the cooking. You're bringing them what it is that they want from your institution. And so that is my hope, that we will be able to work with you. And in everybody's job, there's always things that have to get done. You know, you got to address the latest, you know, updates from Microsoft or IBM, latest updates from Gensler. You got to keep the servers up and running. All these things have to get done. But if we can do them for you and for hundreds of others, faster, better, cheaper, and that's our job to make sure that it is faster, better, cheaper, that we can then help you focus on the things that matter most for your institution. And as I often do here at JAM, I want to once again make this offer to you. For anybody who's here in attendance at JAM, we're offering you 60 days of free, that's a good price, free cloud hosting, for all of the JAM attendees. And so we hope that you'll go sign up and you'll try it. You know, it's a little bit, like I've said in the past, like bringing the puppy home to the kids after Christmas. You know, if you bring this puppy home, if you don't like it, after 60 days, you can drop it. Just like we would say that, you know, if you brought the puppy home from the pet store, if the kids didn't like it after, you know, 60 days, you can bring it back in January or February. Well, give it a chance. Give it a try. Go see Ben and his team and, you know, let's see what we can do with getting more and more of you onto our help with cloud and managed services. And we know that the response rates and the results so far have been great, and I think they will be for you as well. So this is where we've gotten to so far with Gensler One. But we don't want to stop here. Today, I want to announce another big step forward on our Gensler One strategy for our Gensler One platform. And this was something that Ling came up with the name, and you won't be surprised to hear that she called it the Gensler One Freedom Platform. So as we climb up the Matterhorn here, we take our next step up with the Gensler One Freedom Platform. Now, what do we mean by the Gensler One Freedom Platform? Well, actually, in many ways, it's nothing new. It's something that we've been doing with you for many years. When we see there are technologies out there that you want to use, we need to give you the freedom to be able to integrate those into our system in a way that makes it available to you in a way that is the most powerful for you and your institutions. One example that comes immediately to mind is that many of you for many years have used PowerFades for financial aid. We hope now that we have our new Gensabar financial aid system, you'll take a look at it. But some of you will choose to continue to stay with PowerFades because it's something you're used to and something that you like and it works for you. And we understand that. And so we want to make sure that through our Freedom platform, as this is an example of it, that we're able to provide you with the financial aid manager integration that helps you to do that. But we're taking a step forward from there. So the concept that we have for our Freedom platform is like this. So we start with the current integrations that we currently have already done for you. So we have FAM that I just mentioned. For those of you that wanted to tap into the Salesforce technology for recruiting through our Gensabar Recruiting Manager product, we've worked with you and our services team in Informatica to come up with an integration that will work for you with JRM. There are other custom integrations we've done and other integrations that we currently have. All of those are included as part of our Freedom platform. But with Gensabar One, we now have APIs that will tap into web services with industry standards like REST and SOAP that you can then use to take anything that's out there. Out there in the world today, there's probably 5,000 nodes on that intelligent network. I like to think of this as the platform for the intelligent network. Out there in that intelligent network, there's all kinds of applications, B2C, B2B applications that you can tap into and bring the power of those applications onto your campus to address needs, and you want it to be able to work together with our Gensabar One systems and so our platform. So these APIs and working with our services team will be able to get you there. And we hope that over the next coming years as we go into the future, that we'll develop and we'll create an applications ecosystem with these different applications. And as things like PowerFades become very popular or JRM become very popular across the base of customers, we'll productize those integrations just like we have there so that you'll be able to easily get up and running on more and more technologies that will extend the power of what you're doing. So this is the next new step for the Gensabar One platform and technology. But we don't want to stop there. We want to get to the summit. And so we need to take another step forward. So the third thing that I'm talking about today for the Gensabar One platform is the addition of value-added services. Services that can increase the value that we provide and really drive your institution forward in even further in better ways. So for value-added services, many of them are things that we've talked about for a long time. Back a while ago, at JAM in 2006. I made my entire presentation about ERA. But my ERA is enrollment, retention, advancement. Because those are things that I heard in listening tours in the past and heard again are the areas that continue to be the focus for your institutions. How can we increase our enrollments? How can we retain those students and persist them to get to higher graduation rates? And what we found, and I explained back in 2006, is that it starts with retention. When you drive retention higher, it has a great impact on bringing more students to your institution because people see that people like to stay there, they graduate from there, they come and they stay and they graduate. And so it enhances enrollments, increases enrollments, and helps you recruit students. And then they stay, they graduate, they do well, they love being on your campus. When that retention happens and when they persist to graduation, you get more alumni giving, you get more contributions back and your advancement goes up. So it's a very virtuous circle that is going on here with ER and A. And so we have brought new technologies and new services with our recruiting products, with our retention products, with our new advancement system last year to address these areas in both services and in technology. And we want to keep advancing in this area. We want to keep helping you. In some ways, you could say that while I said I was happy to just wash the dishes, I actually also want to help with the cooking. I want to help you to increase the number of students, that you have at your institutions and to see them stay and thrive and graduate and become alumni of your institutions. So we're going to continue as part of our Zanzibar One strategy to focus on how we can make those value-added services work even better for you. And if you're noticing in the title of my slide, I've slipped in this URL that some genius in our company, not me, went out and got in 1992. I didn't even know you could get, Ben told me about it. I didn't even know you could get a URL in 1992, but he went out and got it, and we now own campus.com. And campus.com, we think, is a great thing to help all of our institutions. And as Ling has come back to get more involved in the company, she's been focusing on the challenges that you all have and how we can help more by bringing more enrollments and increase enrollments online as well as on ground. But with campus.com, we think that we have something that we can go back out into the marketplace with and help you bring online enrollments. So we think that we can build online enrollments to this URL. It's something we're going to be working on over the course of the next year with you, and I'm looking forward to being able to have many of you join with us in this. Because if you look at what's happened in the online enrollment world, certain schools have been able to accumulate way more than what you would call their fair share of the online market. It happened way earlier on with the for-profits like University of Phoenix, but they've actually been fading. They've been going down. Their enrollments online have been decreasing. At the same time, the public institutions have picked up a bit. They're growing about 5%. But the private institutions are growing like 10, 12%. They're the ones that are growing even the fastest out there. So publics and privates, the nonprofit sector is growing, but not evenly across the market. Instead, we see that there are certain institutions that are getting more than their fair share. And they're not all brand names. Southern New Hampshire is one that, we know the president and they've done a great job there. I wouldn't have, if you said MIT, I heard of them, 20 years ago, I'm not sure I heard of Southern New Hampshire, but they've become big and online and so have many others like them. And so we want to be able to work with you and to strike back at that and to provide that value-added service. So we're looking forward to all three parts of Zanzibar One platform rolling out. So the first part is ready now. The Zanzibar One products and services, including those managed services and cloud services that are so critical to making that a successful launch for you. So we really hope that everybody in the room will seriously look at getting on board for Zanzibar One product services, managed services, and cloud services. Then we want to work with all of you to see what technologies we want to integrate in. We don't want to just let anybody in, we'll keep the Russians out, but we want to make sure that the technologies and the vendors that you want to work with, are able to integrate into the Zanzibar platform and be able to give you the value that you want out of that application ecosystem, out of those 5,000 companies out there that are starting up all the time and bringing new things that might be of interest. And then finally, we want to take that third step, that third part, and work with you on value-added services and help you to grow those, including with our new offering for campus.com. Now, I've put all of this in front of a picture of the Matterhorn, because I recognize that, it might feel like it's a big climb. It's a lot to do. There's all these things I'm talking about. My goodness, we have a day job. We got stuff to get done. You want us to do all these new things. Well, our job is to take that Matterhorn and turn it into a nice grassy hill that we can all just stroll up together and then come to the top of the hill and sit together and have a nice conversation under the shade of the tree. So that's our job, to make this an easier climb. And that's what we're committed to do. And we know that many of you are going to be willing to work with us to make this an easier climb for everybody here in the room. Now, how are we going to do that? How are we going to make this an easier climb? Well, once again, it's back to our greatest asset. And each year at JAM, we are able to award our Cornerstone Award to somebody from Zanzibar, a Zanzibar associate who over many years has been making a big difference for all of our clients. And so this is really a thrill to be able to do this. So as we talked about it and as I thought about it for this year, who should it be? Who should be given this great award? And it was so obvious. It should be the team that got the Zanzibar One student and financial system, the business office system, done a year early. This great team, they worked day and night. You know, I know how stressed out they were, even leading up the last couple of months to JAM, to get it all done and to have it ready to go here and to be able to start implementing it at Polk and to see it come live at Baker and all the great things that they've been doing. So on behalf of this team, I would like to recognize our own Les Zimmerman as this year's Cornerstone Award winner. Yay, Les! Les, if you're in the room, stand up and let's take a bow. Thank you very much for being our Cornerstone recipient and for making such great progress over so many years as our Chief Technology Officer. Of course, we know that Les can't do it alone. So also, at this time at JAM, we get to recognize somebody from our client base who's been working with us to make it possible. Again, we look for someone who's made contributions over many years as we've brought new technologies to the market. And I've had the privilege of working with Donna Carroll, who's the president of this institution, for many years. And Donna has been a great friend, and she's always willing to put herself out there and to take a chance on new technologies and to push the ball forward. And we know it's not easy, but she's always been willing to do it. And of course, she couldn't do it without the great team that she has as well. And so we have a couple of them in the room, as well as others from Dominican. So let me recognize Jill Albin Hill and Pete Peterson. Wherever you are, could you please stand up and take a bow? And let's give them a big round of applause. Jill just continues to serve. Today she was on the panel at our executive track session on student engagement and doing wonderful things there. So thank you for all you're doing. But Dominican would be the first one to tell us that it's not them alone. There are so many others in this room that have been making a meaningful and important contribution in very many ways and very many areas. And I want to be able to recognize all of you who are members of our Gensabar Community Advisors, and to invite and hopefully entice others in the room who aren't members of our Community Advisors yet to come on board. We would love to have all of you working with us on different areas of advisement so that we can move forward together. So a big round of applause for over 200 members of our Community Advisors here with us at JAM. And because of the way that we have learned to work together, we actually stay together. In many ways, I think of Gensabar as the Gensabar nation, the Gensabar family that stays together. And here, again, I get the opportunity and the honor to recognize institutions who've been with Gensabar for 25 years or more. All of these institutions have been with Gensabar for 25 years and are being welcomed into the Gensabar 25-year academy. They join a group together numbering over 170 institutions who've been with Gensabar for at least 25 years, some going into their fifth decade. Let's give a big round of applause to those who've come this far with us. You know, if you stop and think for a minute about how technology's changed in 25, 30, 40 years, it's just so amazing. When I think about it, it's just so amazing how technology has changed. And so what I've learned from this group of clients is that we have to work together to advance as the technology changes. And so it's about being able to be together and to work together to change with the technology and move forward. It's not about just what the technology is today, it's about where it's going and being able to look forward. And so we just benefit so much from having institutions that have been with us for this long and have helped us come along for all these years. And you know, that's something that does not go unnoticed in the marketplace. When we go out to try to bring new clients into Gensabar, one of the things that they often do, even though we don't give them permission, is they call all of you up. They find you, they know you, and they talk to you about your experience with us. And it's the ability to have these long-term relationships that starts to strike a chord with new clients. And so we are so happy to have new members joining the Genzibar community since last jam. All of these institutions have become new members of the Genzibar community since the last jam. If you see them in the hallways or in sessions, please give them a big, warm welcome to the Genzibar family. And let's give these new institutions, as part of our family, a big round of applause. You know, it's really fun for me and hopefully for you to come to JAM every year. And one of the things that we try to do at JAM is to bring partners here who have interesting technologies that you're either currently using on some of your institutions or you might be interested in. And of course, to get their financial support to make JAM even more successful. And they set up in the Universe Room. They're there for you to go and to see what they have to offer and to see whether it's something that might be of interest to your institution. And so I want to thank all of our exhibitors and sponsors who are here with us today, starting with Herring Bank, who's our platinum sponsor this year. CashNet, now Blackboard Transact, is also here as our gold sponsor. Digiarc and TMS are silver sponsors, and we have a set of bronze sponsors and exhibitors all here with us in the Universe Room, all ready to be helpful to you and hopefully already working with a number of your institutions. So for their financial support and their great technologies that they bring to offer to us, I want to give them a warm welcome to Nashville and to JAM. So when I think about all of us, you know, customers who are new, these people who are our exhibitors, all of our associates, those of you who have been with us for 25 years or more, those of you who are core client base that have been coming on board over the more recent years, all of us, I think of as a diverse group. We've got many different types of institutions coming from many different places in the country and the world. But even though we're a diverse group, I find that we have one thing in common, and that is a common set of values. And these values have been the core of what we did with the Genzibar Foundation. Over a decade ago, we formed the Genzibar Foundation to reflect the values that we saw on your institutions, with your students, as well as with ourselves. And over the last, now going into our second decade, we've been able to work with student organizations on your campuses that have wanted to make a difference in the world, both near and far. And so over that time period, we've partnered with over 600 student organizations on your campuses, giving them grants to make a difference in the world. And we've seen so many great things beyond just the great scholars that you're producing, so many students who are really out there caring about the world, and it's a great way for them to get started in their career. These are wonderful students doing wonderful things and helping others. And so it's also been one of the things that we focused on with the Genzibar Foundation to see how we could help them. And in some cases, they too need help to be able to continue in their education. They need scholarship, they need assistance. And in some cases that are near and dear to my heart, there are people who have actually had life circumstances deal them a blow that makes it hard for them to pursue their higher education. One group that I've worked with for many years is the Fallen Patriots organization. And these guys work with hundreds of students who have lost a parent in the line of duty, or maybe a spouse. They help them to go back to go to school and to make up that difference that they need to be able to complete their education. And we provide scholarships just for our institutions, but we provide scholarships through this organization for all of you. So if you're interested in those kind of students, there's a certain designation that your enrollment people know when they apply. We have a scholarship available for you to help them bring them to your campus. In the last year, we also decided to partner with the Red Sox to do 170 scholarships for students to go anywhere in the country. I know I'm a Red Sox fan, sorry about that. I know many of you are from different cities and you root for other teams, they're all good teams. But this scholarship was for students from states, not just in Massachusetts, all over, and they can go to whatever institution they want, you know, and I know that a number of them chose your institutions, and we hope to continue to actually encourage and profile more of your institutions in scholarship opportunities like that as we bring the opportunity for people who have, in this case, a financial need, they had the grades to get in, and they were being recognized not for those two things alone, but also for the fact that they had done some great community service and they had done something in their community that made them stand out, and that's very fitting with our whole humanitarian theme. So we found it an attractive thing to do. For the last decade, I've also served on the board of One Family. And One Family takes women who were formerly homeless and gets them on the track to getting their higher education, usually starting out in community colleges, getting them through those programs, working hard with them. And we've had great success. For those of you who know about the community college retention rates and success to graduation, you'll be impressed to know that we've been able to graduate 82% of the women that have entered this program. And these were challenging cases where we were getting accessibility for higher ed to people who normally wouldn't be able to get it. They had been in homeless situations and difficult situations. And that has taught us how much talent there is out there. One of the women that we supported, she started a community college. She graduated, did well. She went on to a four-year college to Tufts in the Boston area. She went through the four-year program. She graduated, she did well. She was admitted to Harvard Law School. She went through Harvard Law School. She graduated from Harvard Law School. She did well. The national media descended on her and put her on national television saying, homeless to Harvard. Amazing story. And so we know that there are many great people out there who, if they're just given the chance, they're going to do wonderful things in their education and in the world. And so we provide scholarships, again, just for our institutions, but we provide plenty of them. Hundreds of women have been helped through this this program to be able to graduate. And we hope that we can look to work with many of you to continue to do these kinds of scholarship opportunities and others as well. So, you know, where does this DNA come from? You know, all of you will know for you yourselves, individual and your institutions, how it is that we've developed and you've developed the heart to do this. I know for our company, one of the great inspirations has been our founder, Ling Chai. And she also started her own nonprofit organization called All Girls Aloud. And All Girls Aloud became a ministry that was focused on helping women and girls around the world to have life, value, and dignity, particularly in places where they were getting none of that. So one big opportunity that they saw, and it was a horrible situation in China with the one-child policy, where they were dragging women off the street over the last 30 years and forcing them to have abortions when they wanted to have more than one child, or when their age was not 25 and they didn't have a birth permit, even if they didn't have any children. And this horrible policy was going on, and Ling and her team went to work to try to put an end to this gendercide where so many babies were being prevented from being born to mothers who wanted to have them. And through a lot of hard work, and after her conversion in 2009 and her religious experience, she just dedicated herself and testified in Congress and did so many great things to bring about this, confronting again the government of China to change this policy. Being a doubting Thomas, I thought, yeah, good luck with the government of China, trying to get them to change. But through persistent work and through some help from people in our government and through a lot of work by a lot of people, the pressure was put on and they changed the policy. In each of the last 3 years, 1 million babies have been born each year who would not have been legal in the past, and 13 million of those babies who had been born as so-called, you know, black children, they were like in the dark and in the dungeon, they weren't allowed to be legal in the country, they didn't have any hoku, they couldn't get any health care, they couldn't get any education, they couldn't get any passport. Those 13 million little babies are now legal in China, and I want to give Ling a big hand of applause for being dedicated to making this happen. Now, of course, you know, we all know Ling from when she started Genzibar 20 years ago. We were together in this house, our house in Harvard Square, and she started Genzibar in the basement of this house, actually in the loft with her dog, and then she moved into the basement and got us going 20 years ago. So as we thought about like a keynote speaker for our 20th anniversary, we thought, you know, we don't have to look very far. We got our own celebrity right in front of us here. Let's let her do the keynote for the 20th anniversary and bring us both a perspective on where we came from, but very importantly, where she thinks that we can go in the next 20 years. And Ling has come back as our president and CEO now, joining myself, and she is all fired up to lead us into the next 20 years. Now, some of you in this room have known Ling for most of these 20 years, and others of you have never heard of her. You don't know who she is. So in order to make sure that you have a little bit of background on the person who the media calls Chai Ling, give me just a few minutes of your attention for this video to introduce our founder and president and CEO, Chai Ling. Thank you very much.